Hey team, here I am again. As promised, today I give you the same problem in a long version and a short version. So if you are watching this, you are watching the short version of me solving this problem. That means I'm going to go a lot faster and then there's going to be a lot less explanation. If you are watching this video and you are like, what is she doing? What is she talking about? This is weird. This makes no sense. Stop watching this video and go watch the long version where I go a little slower and explain things a little more clearly. All right, if you've done some of this before and you just want a quick refresher, then this is probably the video for you because I'm gonna go quickly and I'm not really gonna explain each step. I'm just gonna kind of refresh your memory on each step, all right? So I wrote it out as an area problem today just to remind us when we're finding area, we're multiplying length times width. So what is the area of a rectangular room that is 3 1/9 feet by 4 1/8 feet? So that means I am multiplying 3 1/9 by 4 1/8. One quick thing here, you'll notice instead of using an X for multiplication, I used a dot. That is a super fancy middle school thing that you're gonna learn a lot more about in middle school, but basically it's because in middle school you're gonna start having letters in your equations, and X, like multiplication, happens to be a letter that is very commonly used in math. So basically, once you're in middle school, you probably won't use the X for multiplication anymore. You're going to use a dot or parentheses instead. So here you go, a little preview. All right, so the big thing, first we need to convert. It is a huge pain in the tush to multiply mixed numbers if you don't convert them to improper fractions. It's possible, but it is a pain in the tush and it takes a long time. So we're gonna do it a little bit quicker and we are gonna turn these into improper fractions. So turning this into an improper fraction is gonna be 28/9, and this one here in an improper fraction is gonna be 33/8. Now, we're gonna connect these because really we're multiplying here and multiplying down here. Now, before I multiply, because I don't wanna make a ton of work for myself by multiplying 28 and 33 and then multiplying 9 and 8 and then having to do this big old division problem, I don't wanna do that. So instead, I'm going to simplify. Because I turned both of my fractions into one big fraction, now I can do whatever I want to the top and the bottom with any of these numbers. So what that means here is I don't have to simplify this fraction and this fraction. Instead, I could simplify this fraction or this fraction. All right, I can do whatever I want. That's the beauty of fractions, is as long as you do it to a number on the top and a number on the bottom, you can literally just do whatever you want. Have a party, go nuts. So here's what I'm gonna do. I notice that 28 and 8, ooh, I don't wanna do that color. That's gonna be a pain in the, I gotta use better language, a pain in the behind for you guys. So I'm so sorry if your parents are watching. They're like, what's wrong with your teacher? Okay, so I'm going to simplify. I realize that 4 is a common factor for both of these. If I divide 28 by 4, I'm going to get 7. If I divide 8 by 4, I'm going to get 2. Now, 4 is definitely not a common factor for 9 and 33, but when I look at this, the greatest common factor for these is going to be 3. 9 divided by 3 is going to be 3, and 33 divided by 3 is going to be 11. This problem looks way more comfortable to work with. So now, instead of multiplying 28 by 33 and making a headache for myself, I can multiply 7 times 11, which will be 77. And now I can multiply 3 times 2, which will be 6. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So now I have a lovely improper fraction as an answer. However, we don't work with improper fractions. It's annoying in real life. You don't want this. You're never going to go to the store to, you know, buy an amount of feet of flooring for this weird little tiny rectangular room and tell the store clerk, hi, I would like 77/6 feet of flooring. They're going to be like, oh my gosh, leave. So we don't want that. It's bad. Just no. So we need to simplify this into a mixed number. That means that we are going to figure out 6 can go into 77. You might know this one in your head from your math facts. It's going to be 12 times 6 is 72. you guys could be writing this out if you wanted. Like this is gonna be 12, this is gonna be 72, subtract. You're gonna have 5 remaining. Now remember, we know we can write remainders with an R. That's cool, but we don't want that. We can also find an exact value by creating an equivalent decimal, but we don't want that right now either because that's not what we're doing. We're doing fractions. So when we are doing fractions, we really are saying, well, how many times can 6 go into 5 or 5 divided by 6? Well, another way to write 5 divided by 6 is literally a fraction, 5 over 6. So that means 12 and 5 sixths is a completely simplified answer. The only thing I need to add is my label. I put feet squared there. Remember, when, especially if you're typing your answers online, you're probably not going to use that little 2. You might write square feet or feet squared. That's it, team. We did it. Beautiful, beautiful work. I miss you so much. I hope you're having an amazing time at home. I hope if you have questions, you reach out to me. Let me know. I want to help you guys. And I hope you guys liked my little shark up here too, because I drew them just for you guys. All right. Love you bunches. And